Hi, I'm Bryce Merkl Sasaki, and I'm here at Graph Connect Europe in London with Nicolas Rouyer from Orange. So, talk to me about how you guys use Neo4j at Orange, and if you, you know, what new projects you're starting on.
At first, we studied the use of Neo4j for IT supervision use cases, and we at Orange Business Services have issued an offer. Public offer to propose IT supervision to Fortune 500 companies. So this is our main offer, and internally we use Neo4j to find you know, security issues on the information system, and also to have an urbanistic point of view on IT. So most of the time we consider servers or network elements separately, and with graph syncs you can connect them and have a zoom out view of things.
Okay, great. And why did you guys choose Neo4j in the first place? What made it stand out to you guys?
I personally was looking for some search path problems, you know, shortest path and so on. It was completely different from Orange use cases, but I was looking for a solution, and I went into Neo4j at a Parisian meetup. And then it occurred to me that this solution could be of great added value for IT. Okay. Then we fell on other possible use cases, such as churn reduction in telecom companies, and also training recommendations for human resources. And it also occurred to us that some use cases could be transposed from telco to human resources. For example, churn reduction could be adapted to human resources if we know the interactions between employees. We could have an insight of some communities that could churn together, get back to the enemy, and so on.
Yeah. Okay, great. And then what are some of the most surprising or interesting results you've seen after using Neo4j?
Most of the time, we found something we didn't thought of. It's like our connections in our brains were just apparent, and in the graph they are stored, and so the connections work. Sometimes graph database is better than our brains, but we tried to dig into the systems, establish relationships, refine the graphs. The first model is not the good one. We have to refine it till it's a good adequation with reality.
Yep. Okay. And then what were, like, if you could take everything you know about Neo4j now and go back to when you first started, what would you do differently, or what would you tell yourself?
I would pinpoint on data modelization. I think it's the most important thing in NoSQL in general and in graph database. You have to have a first insight of what data model you should use, and prepare that in your mind. I mean, just draw things on the whiteboard. But in graphs, it's not that that important after all, because your model can be a failure at the beginning, and if you refine it, if you you can make it an agile way to refine the model. So after all, we did not sort not so many errors. I mean, after all.
There you go.
And I think also that at first we tried to integrate softwares together. I mean, the ETL things, the graph database at the core, and above some some business tools such as a business analytics tool, Tableau, ClickView, and so on, ClickSense. And we managed to do that connections, which was quite good. But now we think at users' point of view, we can offer them adequate and dedicated interfaces, which we develop easily, such as with Spring Data and so on. Okay. So maybe using more frameworks, open source frameworks, to ingest data and visualize them.
Mm-hmm. Okay, awesome. So anything else you'd like to add or say? Any other closing thoughts?
Yeah, I live in Toulouse, southwest France, and we have a great growing community of graphistas, which is more than 300 people now. And so we welcome anyone who is interested. And we can see that after the years, the community is more mature now. And they, for example, we were able to propose practical workshops when people dig into ciphers and so on. It's not only a presentation of use case. It's also a practical workshop with open data, for example, open food facts. We wrote, after this workshop, a graph gist on open food facts. And I think this is a sign that this community in Toulouse is growing fast and will offer more and more subjects and graphs.
Yeah. Okay, great. Well, thank you so much for talking today. It was great to catch up. And
It was a pleasure for me. And the journey was of great value for me too.
So, great, thank you.